Okay, I'm going to show you the APH Draftsman drawing board now. This has, the little clippies are on the end. That's how you hold the paper down. And then it's got this extra, it's different. It's this film that normally, again, when you work on the surface, it's supposed to lift it up. And I really prefer this film on the Draftsman to that this other flimsier paper, that plastic that comes with the Sewell raised line drawing board. However, I'm gonna be just very honest that I am scared to death to use a compass like this with the Draftsman because of this very, very pointed edge. So I'm not going to feel comfortable in using this or the APH compass on the Draftsman because I'm so afraid I'm going to ruin the surface. And so in that particular case, I'm going to see if I can't manage to use the Fiskars and show you what you might be able to do on this surface. But again, I'm just very, very worried about ruining the surface of my Draftsman. So let me see if I can use my tech. In fact, what I'm going to do, I think might work a little better since I did such a terrible job with the pen. I'm going to try and use the stylus. So remember how I said the Fiskars was nice because you could put anything in it. So I'm going to put the stylus that really normally fits right there, and I'm going to try to put that in and see if I can get this to work a little bit. And again, it's just the fact that this does have a little bit of a tip on it, but it's rubber. I'm going to see if I can't do that. So I'm going to hold on and see if I can't get this. I'm not going to make it too wide. See if I can get this to work for us. So I have got a raised line. I'm going to try it again. I think this film also prefers you're writing on it in a regular way, but I think we're getting there. Okay. So again, I hope this demonstrates it's the right instrument, right tool, right drawing board, and you can do it. And what's nice about this particular film is, and I'm just looking at that. I'm looking at the camera and thinking, wow, that really looks good on the camera. So again, I've drawn my concentric circles. Even though this looks white, there is enough definition that the sighted math teacher could probably look at that from somewhat of a distance and see that the student has drawn those concentric circles. So again, I use a very light touch. Again, the stylus is no problem because that comes with the tool. And this tip has that rubber tipped edge. So I love the Draftsman, but again, because I love it so much, I am just a little bit scared to try to use something like this that's got such a pointed edge. I'm just so afraid I'm going to ruin the surface. If you want to try it, let you go ahead and try it and report back to me, please. If you were successful and didn't ruin your Draftsman, or maybe you just kept one Draftsman just for that purpose. But again, I've shown you that you can use what would normally be considered a compass for a sighted person. And this time, instead of putting that ballpoint pen that I was having a lot of difficulty with a little earlier, I'm just putting the stylus that comes with and normally nestles right down here in the tray. Okay, just don't lose that. And that's what I tend to do. So be very careful about not losing that stylus. And then you'll be able to draw your concentric circles on your Draftsman. Okay, I think that I have used just about everything I've got to show you how to draw concentric circles.